Back to another episode of the Sneaky Stacks. Guys, I apologize for not being able to get a video up last week as I had a crazy paper that was due and just a bunch of other stuff going on as far as real life goes. So I wasn't able to get there, but I know Ryan had an amazing video up for a first look and also the fastest 2 minutes in football. He did a great job there. So we are back, though, with another Sneaky Stacks. We know that a lot of the big games this week, we know who the high-flying offenses are. We're going to be looking at a couple of stacks, as usual, that are going to be a little bit lesser owned, or at least projected that way, and then also a couple of reasons why we like them, and just to kind of get you some leverage, some other options, because obviously these guys at the top, Herbert's been killing it, Patrick Mahomes, Aaron Rodgers, Prescott, Stafford, all are going to be great plays. Maybe not Prescott going up against New England, but honestly, kind of like that there. But that being said, my first stack that I like is actually going to be the Washington football team. I really like Tyler Heinicke this year just because he is doing a lot of great plays in the air, also a little bit of rushing as well. You do see that one rushing touchdown against Buffalo this year, and you see three games over 20 points. You do see that last game against New Orleans, who has a pretty good defense that was able to stop a lot of what Heinicke and the Washington football team wanted to do as a whole. He still threw the ball for 40 times. He's getting the volume that you like to see. And really, it is strange because outside of the Giants game, you're seeing some of his best games are when he had, had 24 attempts, but he was able to get that rushing touchdown in that game. So that's why he had a good game there. And then Atlanta, he had 33 attempts, and that was strong as well. So I do like Tyler Heinicke in this game just because I don't think the Kansas City Chiefs can guard anything defensively. And so he should be able to have a good game there. And who I like to pair him up with is if you take Tyler Heinicke. I don't mind J.D. McKissic or Antonio Gibson. I really like McKissic, actually, if Gibson's going to be out with that the shin issue that he has going on. I believe it's a stress fracture there. I think he's going to play. But that being said, I do really liked either Terry McLaurin. Obviously, he's going to be more expensive, but I really like any of these other guys. It doesn't look like Curtis Samuel is going to play, but De'Ami Brown might play. Adam Humphries, the ghost, is also going to play, so I don't mind stacking both of them with Tyler Heinicke. You're probably going to get maybe 10 points out of each because you're going to see some touchdowns being scored by Washington football team, because as of a complete flip from last year, they're actually a good offense, and their defense is going to be what is lacking. So Kansas City hasn't been able to be proven that they can stop anything on defense. We thought that it was going to be how you beat them is just run the ball and keep the ball out of Patrick Mahomes' hands. That doesn't seem to be the case. It's actually causing turnovers against Kansas City. It seems to be what's been working against some of these games, and also being able to do whatever you want against them offensively. So that is one reason why I like the Washington football team as my top sneaky stack of the week. The second one that I like, we're going to go to Chicago. We keep waiting for Justin Fields to have that big game. I don't think it's going to necessarily happen this game that we know of. However, I do like Herbert here, as we just found out that Damian Williams is going to be on the COVID list. That being said, Khalil Herbert is going to be a smash spot. I don't think that this is going to be something where he is going to be a strong GPP pivot play. But again, if we're going to build a stack here, and then I really like if you go in Allen Robinson, who a lot of people have hated this week or this year. I think he's going to be a strong play if he does play. If he doesn't, I think you like Mooney just as well, who has been performing better than Robinson just straight up when Fields has been the quarterback. So I like this stack here the most, especially if Allen Robinson is going to be playing. You have Jair Alexander, the number one corner on Green Bay, not going to be playing in this game as he is on the IR. So I really like this stack as well. Fields, Herbert, and Mooney, as I believe that the Bears should be able to move the ball. I also think they're going to be able to run the ball pretty well. Again, Herbert, I know, doesn't necessarily fit the sneaky side, but I think pairing him with the quarterback and the wide receiver there is something that a lot of people are probably going to stay away from, because I think typically you see Green Bay as a strong defense, especially because of Jair Alexander, and you've seen people kind of be down on the Fields passing game already. But I think this is a game where he definitely could have an opportunity to shine. And finally, we're just kind of flying through these, but the last one that I like is actually the Houston Texans. Yes, I'm going to be a believer based off of what they did last week against the Patriots. It takes a really, really solid play to go from negative 0.3 to 27 points. It's got to be one of the largest swings in fantasy history. If you guys have the answer to that, of who is the largest swing, feel free to leave that in the comments section. But to go from negative 0.3 to 27, especially against this New England defense, over in Prize Picks, I picked over on the New England defense of 9 points, and I got burned by that because I thought there was no chance that Davis Mills was going to do anything. They have proven that they were able to do some pretty strong things. You do have the Colts coming off a short week where they played an emotional game Monday night and lost. They also lost a couple of their cornerbacks. They got thin there, especially with Xavier Rhodes going down. So that's why I like pairing him up with either Brandon Cooks. You have Chris Conley. Anthony Miller just got signed to the Steelers, so he's not going to be one of your options here for the Texans. But Chris Moore is, who did receive that big touchdown last week and did get signed off of the practice squad. So I think if you're looking at something like this for a stack, I think you're in a pretty good spot as well. So the three sneaky stacks I like, the Houston Texans, I like the Chicago Bears, and the Washington football team as my three sneaky stacks. Not necessarily sure who I'm going to go with the thumbnail on this because it's not, there's not really a lot of sexy plays here. But again, that's the whole point, is to try to get some leverage on the field. So please feel free to leave any picks that you guys like as far as sneaky stacks below. I'd be more than happy to check those out and see if we can include those in the final breakdown for you. But again, the news that Damian Williams is going to be on the COVID list this week is definitely huge and opens up a lot of opportunities for Herbert. So those are the picks. Thanks guys for listening. Feel free to like and subscribe. Until next time.